Before recording any transaction, the accountant should first ensure that the source documents for the transaction exist. Source documents provide evidence that the recorded transaction actually occurred. These documents can include, for example, purchase invoices, bank checks, contracts, and sales invoices. Once the source documents are reviewed by the accountant and proper approvals secured, the accountant then records the transaction. Never ever record any transaction without proper supporting documents. Accountants record the transactions in journals like this one here, and that step is known as journalization. A journal is a detailed record of all the financial transactions of the business. It shows the date of the transactions, the accounts affected by the transactions and by what amounts, along with a brief description of the transaction. Let us journalize our previous example where Mr. Stick deposited $100,000 in a bank account on January 1st to start his business. Insert the date of the transaction here. To identify the accounts affected by the transaction, the accountant refers to a list of accounts called the chart of accounts. This list includes all the accounts that the accountant uses in recording business transactions. Each account has a name and a unique number. The account number can have two or more digits. Account numbers for assets accounts start with 1, liability accounts start with 2, 3 for equity accounts, 4 for revenue accounts, and 5 for expense accounts. In our example, the accounts affected by the transaction are the cash account, which is an asset account, and the capital account, which is an equity account that is used to record the owner's contribution to the business. Then the accountant should determine whether there is an increase or decrease in each of the identified accounts. Here, our transaction increased the cash account by $100,000 and also increased the capital account by the same figure. Using the debit and credit rule, the increase in the cash account is recorded by debiting cash by $100,000, and the increase in the capital account is recorded by crediting the capital account by $100,000. A brief description is written about the transaction. After recording the transaction, the source documents should be filed, and a reference number is written here that traces the entry to its source documents for future reference. Let us practice with journalizing few transactions.